好，我们来看一下本课的 key structures 关键句型。在第55课中间，我们首先讲解一下 used to do 以及 would 用法。used to 和 would 都能用来描述在过去某段时间之内的习惯动作或者经常干的事情。一般来说，我们用 used to 来开始一段故事。used to 可以用来表示现在和过去形成对比，而 would 则不能。好，比如说，我过去总是乘公共汽车去上班，而现在我开车去上班。前后对比关系，我们使用 used to do。I used to go to work by bus. Now I go by car. I used to go to work by bus. Now I go by car. 前后对比用 used to do。好，再比如说 ，I have given up smoking. I used to smoke very heavily. 我已经戒烟了，我以前吸烟吸得很凶。I have given up smoking. I used to smoke very heavily. Used to do 又是前后形成对比关系。那么 used to 还能表示过去状态或者情况，而 would 只能表示过去重复的动作，不能表示状态或者情况。好，比如说，这种小说曾经很流行。This sort of novel used to be very popular. This sort of novel used to be very popular. 这个 used to be 表示过去的状态以及情况，不能使用 would 来表达。This sort of novel used to be very popular.而 would 可以表示过去很不规律的习惯，所以常和 often、always、frequently、sometimes 等时间频率副词连用。在非正式文体中间 ，used to do 也可以这样使用。好，我们来看一个短文去体会一下。When I was young, I used to have a lot more free time than I do now. I used to live near my work and would always get home early. Sometimes I would do a bit of gardening or go for a walk.Now, I never have time of anything like that. 我们看一下这段短文是什么含义呢？注意其中 used to 以及 would do 的用法。When I was young, I used to have a lot more free time than I do now. 当我年轻的时候，我比现在有大量的空闲时间。I used to live near my work and would always get home early. 我过去住的离工作地方很近，所以总是很早就回家。Sometimes,I would do a bit of gardening or go for a walk. 有时候我在花园里面干点园艺，或者去散散步。Now, I never have time of anything like that. 现在我从来没有时间去做这些事情了。好，我们注意一下。I used to have a lot more free time than I do now. 这个 used to 用 used to do 表示开始一段故事。当我年轻时候，我总是有大量的时间。I used to live near my work.我住的离工作地方很近。 OK, used to 表示过去某时的状态或者情况，那么这个时候不能使用 would do. And would always get home early, 总是很早到家，那么这个 would do 表示过去经常重复的动作。 Sometimes I would do a bit of gardening or go for a walk. 有的时候我会做一些园艺工作或者去散散步，那么这个 would do 以及 would go 表示经常重复动作，不是很规律动作，搭配一个 sometimes。Now, I never have time of anything like that. 现在我再没有时间去做这样的事情了。 OK, 注意 used to 以及 would do 的用法。那么接下来呢，我们做一些小题，用 would 或者 used to 来填空，注意表达恰当含义。 Number one is, he smoked a lot, but now he has given up. 他吸烟很凶，但现在已经戒烟了。形成前后对比关系应该使用 used to. He used to smoke a lot, but now he has given up.他以前吸烟很凶，但现在已经戒掉了。He used to smoke a lot, but now he has given up. Used to do 表示过去总是这样做。Number two is, it is said pirates had gold here. 据说海盗在这儿藏金子。那么据说海盗总在这藏金子，总是我们可以使用 used to, 或者 would 也可以。Would do 表示过去经常重复的动作。所以这道题中间选择 used to 或者 would 都说得通。It is said parrots used to have gold here. It is said parrots would have gold here. Number three is, the parrots often bury gold in the cave. 第三题是一个跟第二题很类似的，海盗总在这个山洞里面藏金子，表示总是过去常常做某事经常重复的，可以选择 would 搭配 often 这个词。The parrots would often bury gold in the cave.Would often bury gold in the cave. 在非正式文体中间还可以使用 used to. The parrots used to often bury gold in the cave. Number four is, The river be clean. The river be clean. 这个河是很清的，那么想表达是这个河曾经是很清澈的。当表达过去某事状态或者情况的时候，应该是用 used to do。 Would 没有这种用法。 The river used to be clean. The river used to be clean. 这个河过去是很清的。 OK. Number 5 is I'll leave this job for a better one, he said when he was scolded by his boss. 当他被老板责备的时候，他总是说我会辞职找更好的工作的。I'll leave this job for a better one, 表示我会辞职找更好的工作的。他总是说 He would say, 表示过去经常重复的动作。He would say when he was scolded by his boss. 选择 would do, 表示过去总重复的动作。OK, 好，以上是关于 would 以及 used to do 用法。那么接下来呢，我们看一下分词用法。分词又包括现在分词和过去分词。现在分词是动词加 ing 形式变成的，而过去分词规则变化是动词加 ed 形式，不规则变化需要带特殊来记忆的。首先我们看一下分词性质。那么分词具有形容词或者副词性质，可以在句中担任表语、定语、宾语补足语或者状语。其中现在分词表示主动的含义或者动作正在进行着，而过去分词表示被动含义或者动作已经发生完了，已经完成了。好，接下来看一下分词的用法。分词在句中可以做表语、做定语、做宾语补足语或者做状语。我们先看一下分词做定语的情况，来看一些短语。 A sleeping baby 翻译成一个正在睡觉的婴儿，那么相当于定语从句来修饰 A baby who is sleeping. A baby who is sleeping 含义是一致的，翻译成正在睡觉的婴儿。那么A running dog, 翻译成一条正在跑的狗。A running dog, 正在跑的狗。可以还原为定语从句 ,A dog which is running, A dog which is running, 正在跑的狗。再比如说一个打碎了的杯子。A broken glass, A broken glass, 一个打碎的杯子。相当于 A glass which is broken, 用定语从句修饰 ,A glass which is broken。再比如说 ,A beaten team,beat 翻译成打败的意思，那么 a beaten team 表示被打败的一支队伍，相当于 a team which is beaten, a team which is beaten。 好，通过以上四个短语我们来体会一下 sleeping baby 正在睡觉的婴儿， a running dog 正在跑的狗。那么 sleeping 和 running 是个现在分词，表示主动的而且进行的概念。另外两个短语 a broken glass, a beaten teamBroken 和 beaten 是个过去分词，表达被动的和完成的概念。被打碎的杯子，被击败的队伍。OK, broken, beaten, 过去分词表达被动的含义。好，再看下个例句是 This is a problem discussed at the last meeting. 这是上次会议上被讨论的问题。那么句子主干是 This is the problem, 这是问题。这是什么问题呢？ Discussed at the last meeting.上次会议上被讨论的问题，那么也就是说 discussed 过去分词短语做定语就是 problem 这个词的，上次会议上被讨论的问题。那么这句话也能还原成定语从句，表达为 This is a problem which was discussed at the last meeting. Which 引导定语从句就是 problem, 上次会议上被讨论的问题。我们注意一点，在 which 定语从句中间是个被动形式的， which was discussed 被动形式。 OK,好 ,next example is, the problem being discussed is very important. 翻译成正在被讨论的问题是很重要的。那么句子主干是 the problem is very important. 问题是非常重要的。什么问题呢？ being discussed. 正在被讨论的问题是重要的。OK, 那么这个 being discussed 是个现在分词短语做定语修饰 problem. 这句话也能还原成定语从句，表达为The problem which is being discussed is very important. The problem which is being discussed is very important. 那么注意一下 ,which is being discussed, 那 is being 是个进行时态。那么不知道大家有没有这样一个问题，为什么说前四个例句中间 ,sleeping, running, broken, beaten, 这些分词放在名词之前了，而后两个例句中间 ,discussed at the last meeting, being discussed 放在名词之后呢？好，有这样规律，注意一下。单 个分词做定语的时候，放在所修饰名词之前，而分词短语做定语的时候，通常放在所修饰名词之后。OK， 注意这一规律。单个分词做定语的时候，放在所修饰名词之前，而分词短语做定语，放在所修饰名词之后，这是一个规律。另外需要注意的就是，通过以上例句，我们可以体会出来，分词做定语的句子都能改写成定语从句。分词做定语的句子都能改写成定语从句。好，最后区别一点就是现在分词做定语和动名词做定语的区别。现在分词和动名词都是动词加 ing 形式，那么我怎么区别哪个是动名词，哪个是现在分词呢？好，来看一些短语。 A sleeping car, a sleeping baby。 Sleeping 形式是一模一样的， sleep 加 ing 形式。我们来看一下哪个是分词，哪个是动名词。 A sleeping car 翻译成卧铺车厢，那么这个 sleeping 表达某种功能的，它是动名词。 sleeping baby 表示正在睡觉的孩子，那么 sleeping 表示动作正在进行着，它是个现在分词。好，再比如说 a reading room, a reading girl。 其中 a reading room 翻译成阅览室，那么 reading 表达某种功能的， a reading girl 表示正在读书的女孩子， reading 表示动作正在进行着，它是个现在分词。再比如说A swimming pool, a swimming pool 表示游泳池，而 a swimming player 翻译成正在游泳的运动员，正在游泳的选手。那么 a swimming player 这个 swim 表示动作正在进行着， a swimming pool swim 表示某种功能的。好，通过以上短语呢，我们知道了动名词做定语表示某种功能，而现在分词做定语表示动作正在进行着。好，以上是分词做定语的功能。下面我们看一下分词做表语有哪些用法。首先看一些例句。这个消息听起来令人振奋，令人振奋应该是 exciting。 The news sounds exciting, the news sounds exciting。 这个消息听起来令人振奋。那么 exciting 这个词我们非常熟悉了，以前把它当作形容词，叫做令人兴奋的。那么实际上 exciting 它是 excite 加 ing 变来的，它的根本是一个动名词。 OK， 这个消息听起来令人振奋。好，再比如说他们感到非常兴奋，感到兴奋是 excited。 They got very excited, they got very excited。 他们感到非常兴奋， excited 作为形容词表示感到兴奋的，那么实际上 excited 它是动词加 ed 变来的，是个过去分词形式。好，再比如说他的父亲对他的成绩非常满意，满意应该是 pleased。 His father seems pleased with his score, his father seems pleased with his score。 他的父亲对他的成绩显得非常满意。 OK, pleased 也是个过去分词形式，表示感到满意的意思。那么再比如说我的表不见了， My watch is gone, my watch is gone。 gone 是 go 的过去分词，在这做表语，我的表不见了。好，再比如说这本书非常有趣，那么有趣表示令人感兴趣的应该是 interesting, 它是个现在分词形式。 The book is interesting, the book is interesting。 那么他对书感兴趣，感兴趣应该是 interested。 He is interested in the book, he is interested in the book。 他对这本书感兴趣。好，以上是 ing 形式做表语以及 ed 形式做表语。需要注意的是，动词加 ing 形式表示令人怎么样的，动词加 ed 形式表示感到怎么样的。 OK, 这就是现在分词和过去分词做表语的用法。接下来我们看一下分词做宾语补足语的用法。 For example, When I woke up, I found my mother sitting beside me. 当我醒来的时候，我发现妈妈正坐在我旁边。 When I woke up 是个时间状语从句， I found my mother 主谓宾，我发现妈妈，I found my mother, 发现妈妈怎么样呢？ Sitting beside me, 正坐在我旁边。那么后面短语 sitting beside me 是个宾语的补足语，妈妈坐在我旁边， sitting 是个现在分词做宾语补足语。好，再比如说 I'd like to have this package weighed, weigh 作为动词表称的意思，我想找人称一下这个包裹的重量，也就是这个包裹被称。 I'd like to have this package weighed, weighed 做包裹的宾语补足语，是个被动含义的，这个包裹被称一下。 Next example is I hear a bell ringing somewhere, 我听到铃在某地方正在响起。 I hear a bell ringing somewhere, 听到铃正在响是 hear a bell ring。Ring 现在分词表示动的正在进行着。Next example is, I had a tooth pulled off. 我找人把牙拔了出来，那么也就是牙被拔。对牙来讲，牙被拔，那么宾语不足以用被动形式的 pulled。Pulled 过去分词表达被动含义。I had a tooth pulled off. 我的牙被拔了出来。好，再比如说 ，I found a snake eating the eggs. 我发现蛇正在吃鸡蛋。I found a snake eating the eggs. 我发现蛇正在吃鸡蛋。Eating 是个现代分词表达进行含义。蛇正在吃鸡蛋。那如果说我发现蛇吃鸡蛋，这个事情发生完了，我看到蛇吃鸡蛋了，动作发生完了，怎么来表达呢 ？I found a snake eat the eggs. I found a snake eat the eggs. 这个 eat 实际上是 to eat 省略到 to 的一个不定式。OK， 我发现蛇吃鸡蛋了 ，eat 用不定式表示动作已经发生完了。好，那么再比如说，我发现鸡蛋被蛇吃了，可以这样来表达 ：I found the eggs eaten by the snake. I found the eggs eaten by the snake. 对于宾语 x 来讲，那么应该是被吃的，用个 eaten 过去分词表达被动含义。I found the eggs eaten by the snake. 那么这三个句型结构 ：I found the snake eating the eggs. I found the snake to eat the eggs. I found the eggs eaten by the snake. 大家看一下。用现在分词做宾语补足语，用不定式做宾语补足语，用过去分词做宾语补足语，分别是什么含义呢？好，带着这个问题，我们来看一下下面的例句。He heard someone calling him. Calling 现在分词做宾语补足语，翻译成他听到有人正在喊他。Calling 表示进行含义，听到有人正在喊他。那么换个说法 ，He heard his name called. 他听到自己的名字被叫 ，his name called.对于宾语 name 来讲 called 名字被叫，用 called 过去分词表达被动含义。 OK， 那么再比如说 I can't make myself understood because of my poor English， 因为我的糟糕英语，我不能让自己被听懂被理解。 I can't make myself understood because of my poor English. Understood 过去分词表达被理解的含义，让我自己被理解。好，下个例句是I didn't make myself heard because a lot of people cried in the hall. 许多人在大厅里面喊叫，所以我不能让自己被听见。I didn't make myself heard. OK， 我自己被听见。Heard 是个过去分词，表达被动含义。好，分词做宾语补完了，注意几个事项。首先，后接宾语，大家分词做宾语补的常用动词有感官动词 hear， 听到 see， 看到 notice， 注意到。Watch 观看 Feel 感觉的 Find 发现 OK 还有一些实义性动词 Make 让 Let 翻译成让 Have Get 都表示让的含义那么这些动词感官动词实义性动词后面可以加宾语再加分词做宾语补足语好另外还有个问题是现在分词做宾语补足语不定式做宾语补足语还有过去分词做宾语补足语分别是什么含义呢我们来解答这个问题动词不定式做宾语补的时候表示动作全过程而现在分词做宾语补表示动作正在进行着过去分词做宾语补足语表示被动的含义 OK 好以上是分词做宾语补足语用法那么接下来我们看一下分词做状语的用法在学习分词做状语的时候我们一定牢记一句话也就是现在分词表示主动的进行的过去分词表达被动的完成的概念 OK 带着这八个字我们来看一下例句 Number one is If you turn to the left you will find the station 这是个 if 条件句了要是你向左转的话你会看到车站的 If you turn to the left you will find the station OK if 条件句那么这句话大家想一下你向左转你会看到车站那么在从句中间你向左转你转身大家想是主动还是被动呢好应该是主动概念那么主动的选择现在分词 turning 这句话可以这样说 turning to the left you will find the station turning to the left you will find the station 那么通过这样变化之后呢我就把一个主从的条件状语从句变成分词做状语了而且现在分词表达主动概念向左转之后你将发现车站好再看一下下一个例句 As I didn't receive her letter I called her up by telephone 因为没有收到她的信我给她打电话了 这个 as 是个原因状语从句，由于我没有收到他的信。大家想，收到信是主动的，没有收到信呢还是主动的。那么既然主动，选择 receiving 现在分词， receiving 是个现在分词，那么没有收到信，请问直接加 not 否定， not receiving。 这句话可以这样变化一下， not receiving her letter, I caught her up by telephone, not receiving her letter, I caught her up by telephone。 那么经过这样变化之后，把一个原因状语从句变成否定形式的现在分词做状语了， not receiving her letter, 没有收到信，我给她打电话了。Next example is, while I was walking to school, I met a friend. 当我上学的路上，我碰到一个朋友。Walking to school 表示走路去上学。While I was walking to school, I met a friend. 那么 while 引导是一个时间状语从句。时间状语从句中间 ，I was walking to school， 我走路去上学，走路上学也是个主动概念。好，应该选择 walking 现在分词。Walking to school, I met a friend. Walking to school, I met a friend. 那么这里面 walking to school 现在分词做状语，表达时间的概念。下面一个例句是 When she was asked if she had any bad habit, she answered that she was a heavy smoker. 当她被问是否有坏毛病的时候，她说她吸烟吸得很凶。那么问引导一个句子是一个时间状语从句。When she was asked if she had any bad habit, 当她被问的时候，好，被问是个被动形式的，那么被动形式应该选择过去分词 done 的形式， OK, asked, asked, 过去分词表达被动含义。这句话可以这样来变化一下， asked if she had any bad habit, she answered that she was a heavy smoker. Asked if she had any bad habit, she answered that she was a heavy smoker.那么经过变化之后呢，就把一个时间状语从句转化成了过去分词做时间状语。好，首先需要注意一点，就是分词做状语还可以还原成状语从句。以上例句我们都是把一个状语从句简化成了分词做状语，那么同样的，那么再返回句，分词做状语还能还原成状语从句，这是需要注意的第一点。好，另外我们再看一下这几个例句。第一个例句是 If you turn to the left, you'll find the station.主从句的主语都是 you。 第二例句是 As I didn't receive her letter, I caught her up by telephone。 主从句主语都是 I。 第三个例句是 While I was walking to school, I met a friend。 主从句的主语都是 I。 第四个例句是 When she was asked if she had any bad habit, she answered that she was a heavy smoker。 那么主从句的主语都是 she。 也就是说运用此类句型结构的时候，前后注意必须是一致的。那么不一致怎么办呢？来看个例句。If weather permits, I'll start tomorrow. 要是天气允许的话，我明天动身。If weather permits, I'll start tomorrow. 那么这是个主从复合句，是个条件状语从句。从句中间 ,if weather permits, 注意是 weather, 主句中间 I'll start tomorrow, 我将明天动身。那么这一句话大家想一想，你能不能换成分词做状语？要是天气允许的话，我明天动身。那么天气允许，天气允许是个主动概念的，能不能变成说 permitting I'll start tomorrow, permitting I'll start tomorrow, 允许的话我动身，那变成我允许我动身是错误的。这句话当前后主语不一致的时候，我们这样给分词保留一个逻辑主语，把 weather 保留着，这句话就变成了 weather permitting I'll start tomorrowWeather permitting, I'll start tomorrow. 天气允许的话，我明天动身，仍然是个分词做状语，只不过分词前面有个 weather 做逻辑主语。OK, 这样来处理前后主语不一致的情况。好，以上我们重点讲解了分词，包括现在分词和过去分词，在句中可以做表语、做定语、做宾语补足语和做状语成分的作用。那么分词是第二册中间非常重要的语法项目。那么接下来这样，我们通过回顾例句来回忆一下刚讲了哪些用法。我们看一下刚刚讲的例句。 A sleeping baby. A baby who is sleeping. A running dog. A dog which is running. A broken glass. A glass which is broken. A beaten team. A team which is beaten. This is a problem discussed at the last meeting. This is a problem which was discussed at the last meeting.The problem being discussed is very important. The problem which is being discussed is very important. A sleeping car. A sleeping baby. A reading room. A reading girl. A swimming pool. A swimming player. The news sounds exciting. They got very excited. His father seems pleased with his score. My watch is gone. The book is interesting. He is interested in the book. When I woke up, I found my mother sitting beside me. I'd like to have this package weighed. I hear a bell ring somewhere. I had a tooth pulled off. I found a snake eating the eggs. I found a snake eat the eggs. I found the eggs eaten by the snake. He heard someone calling him. He heard his name called. I can't make myself understood because of my poor English. I didn't make myself heard because a lot of people cried in the hall. Hear, see, notice, watch, feel, find, make, let, have, get. If you turn to the left, you find the station. Turning to the left, you find the station. As I didn't receive her letter, I called her up by telephone. Not receiving her letter, I called her up by telephone. While I was walking to school, I met a friend. Walking to school, I met a friend. When she was asked if she had any bad habit, she answered that she was a heavy smoker. Asked if she had any bad habit, she answered that she was a heavy smoker. If weather permits, I'll start tomorrow. Weather permitting, I'll start tomorrow.
好，重点回忆一下，现在分词表示动作正在进行的是主动含义，过去分词表达动作完成的是被动含义。那么接下来呢，我们开始小的练习翻译短语。第一个短语是发展中国家，发展中国家表示正在发展的，应该用现在分词，发展是 develop， 那么答案应该是 developing countries。developing countries 表示发展中国家，那么相反的发达国家，发达国家表示已经发展完了的，应该是 developed， 过去分词表达动作完成的。developed countries 表示发达国家。好，发展中国家是 developing countries， 发达国家 developed countries。再比如说落叶，那么落叶有两种了，一种是地上的落叶，叫做 fallen leaves。fallen 过去分词表动作发生完了， fallen leaves 表示地上的落叶。那么正在飘落的树叶是 falling leaves， falling leaves 表示正在飘落的树叶。 OK， falling 现在分词表动作正在进行着。那么开水有两种了，一种是正在沸腾的开水，100度的开水叫做 boiling water， boiling water 表示正在沸腾的水，而开过的水可能已经凉了，叫做 boiled water， boiled water 表示开过的水。那么落水者，比如说正在水里面扑腾的人是 a drowning person， a drowning person 表示落水者，而溺水者表示淹死的人，溺水者是 a drowned person， a drowned person 表示动作发生完了， a drowned person 表示溺水者。
好，在本课的 key structure 中间，我们重点讲解 used to do， would do 的用法以及分词用法。 OK， that's all for the key structures。